You're with Emma Griffiths on ABC Radio Brisbane.
Now, have a look around your neighbourhood. Have you ever noticed just how many different styles of homes there are in Brisbane? This afternoon, we're going to have a look at a style that goes way back. Before Mission Brown was the colour of the late 70s, before the fibro homes of the 60s, and even before the Queenslander, to a style that's a little more medieval. Today, on Expand Your Brain, we're asking the question, why are there so many Tudor-style homes in Brisbane? It is a bit odd, isn't it? Marianne Taylor is the house detective. Hello, Marianne.
Hi.
I'll just get you to move closer to that microphone, sorry. And so before we answer the question around Tudor homes, what does a house detective do? Because you're the first house detective I have met. What do you do?
It's basically a cute name for architectural historians. So I'm a historian who specialises in researching the history of houses and buildings, and are particularly interested in those of Brisbane and Queensland.
So did you study history?
I did.
Or
I studied
architecture?
I studied a little
both?
Bit of everything. So I studied architectural history, and I also studied heritage conservation as well. So part of, I guess, knowing the history of these old homes is also looking at, you know, how we can maintain them and that sort of thing as well. Mm. And I also threw some archaeology in there just for fun. So I've got a bit of a broad background. But it's all about detective work, really.
Mm, hunting it down. Mm. And do you investigate homes around Brisbane, Queensland, or right across Australia?
Well, wherever someone wants to pay me, basically. So, yeah, I'm happy to travel everywhere, but mainly in Brisbane and southeast Queensland. There's plenty of work there to keep me busy.
What do people ask you to do?
Well, most people want to know when the house was built. That's the main thing I get asked. And although that sounds quite simple, it's really time-consuming to find that out because you have to go to a lot of different sources and cross-reference them and that sort of thing. People also often want to know if the house ever had a name so they can maybe get a nameplate made up as well. Some people are interested in how it's been altered over the years and what the original style was like. And other people want to know what families live there and sometimes want to check details they've been told by neighbour or something like that. So, yeah, it's a diverse range of reasons people would hire me.
Absolutely. They're all questions you kind of really do want answered.
Definitely.
Okay, so onto this question around Tudor homes.
Sure.
Can you describe what a Tudor home is? Like, what are the characteristics you might see on your street?
So a Tudor home, it was part of a bigger movement for what they called an interwar Old English style or English Revival style. So they're what you would probably picture when you think of a traditional English home. So they had steeply pitched roofs, which is really handy when it snows in Brisbane. They had, they're mainly brick and stucco. They have arched entry doors, sort of, you know, medieval tile type doors where it's a big heavy timber door with the dark black hinges and a big knocker or something like that. Chimneys, also great for the Brisbane climate, the fireplace. They'd also generally have a tiled roof, and they sometimes have your sort of lead light windows in small diamond or square panes. So they're basically trying to recreate that romantic medieval appearance of houses in England.
When were they built? You said interwar.
Sure. So there's some early examples from the 1920s, but mainly the 1930s they were built. So I think it was at a time where the traditional timber and tin Queenslander was a bit passe. It was becoming a bit out of date and old fashioned. So people were trying these new styles like the Tudor style and the Spanish Mission style, those kinds of houses. So very popular with the wealthy in Brisbane, trying to create this sense of, I guess, solidarity and the fact that they were, you know, they were here permanently, and they obviously also had the money to spend on bricks and these types of houses because they were more expensive to build.
Do you have any idea how many there are over the greater Brisbane area?
I don't know exactly, but there's definitely, I would estimate, you know, close to maybe 50 spread all over the suburbs. And there's particular pockets in different areas. Clayfield is an absolute hotspot for them. And I think that that's because Clayfield was one of those suburbs that the sort of up-and-coming middle class in the 30s targeted as a sort of prestigious suburb. So they wanted to build their dream homes in that that area. There's also heaps in Ascot and Hamilton, and they're scattered throughout Brisbane, really. There's some at Toowong, there's some at Cooperoo, there's some at Holland Park. So, yes, everywhere, wherever someone wanted to build them.
And then every so often you see one just all by itself a neighbourhood.
They're quite often all by themselves, so it's very strange. It was totally up to what the owners wanted to build.
Does it carry on through to the interior as well? What do they look like inside?
Inside they look like mock medieval manors often. They've got really dark timber panelling around the walls, dark skirting around the floors, picture rails, big brick fireplaces. Often they'll have window seats in the bay windows, and it's quite amazing. They'll have the exposed beams in the living rooms as well. So it seems quite strange. It's a very romantic idea, I guess, for Brisbane, and quite different to the old Queenslanders. And this is also a time where you've got the international modernist style coming in, which was all about getting rid of that decoration and having these sleek modern boxes. So they're a very almost nostalgic look at housing, and sort of, I think people had these idealistic views of what they wanted for their house, but not necessarily perfect for Brisbane's climate.
So say you're a homeowner in Clayfield and you have a Tudor home like this, and you have some of those questions like,
sure,
when was this built? Who has lived here? What's the process you go through as a house detective, Marianne Taylor, to come up with those answers?
The first thing I normally find out is I would get the certificates of title, and that gives me the names of all the owners going right back to the original deed of grant. And from that, when I've got their names, I can search a variety of different sources. But there's lots of clues just in the certificate of title, which can help me work out roughly when it was built. So land tended to start out as big pockets, big portions, and then it was gradually subdivided. So you can look at when these houses on suburban blocks might have been first built. But there's also these great post office directories, which are basically like early day white pages where it lists the residents in a street, but it actually lists them in the order that the postman would have walked. So you can actually work out what house on the street people were living in, if that makes sense.
Wow.
So it'll be sort of, you know, the fifth house on the left from the corner of this street, and you can work out where the house was, and when they first show up in the post office directory will give you a clue as to when the house was first built.
And where are those directories? Are they?
They're available in a variety of sources at the State Library of Queensland and also at the Brisbane City Council archives. And yeah, there's a variety of other sources. There's old sewerage plans. There's just doing a search in the State Library sometimes will bring up old photos if it was a well-known person. And then there's Trove, which is online digitised newspapers, where you can often find birth notices or marriage notices of the people that lived there, which will give you a clue as to when they lived there and what the house might look like, especially if the house was sold. It might list the contents and the rooms.
Are there any real sort of mysteries that you've uncovered or surprises?
There's often surprises. Sometimes you'll find an illegitimate child or two, something like that, that maybe they inherited the property but were never actually recognised in their lifetime. So something like that can be quite interesting. And there's sometimes houses that you just cannot find any information on. They just don't want to give up their secrets whatsoever. But that's pretty rare, thankfully. But yeah, you never really know what you're going to uncover when you start researching a house, which is part of what I love about it.
Mm. And so in particular, we've discussed the Tudor style homes that kind of stand out in the suburbs around Brisbane. Are there any other styles of homes that you look at and go, well, that's interesting? Why did that crop up here?
There's definitely a range of different homes. I think the ones that are most interesting to me are ones that are obviously well ahead of their time in particular streets. So you might, for example, have a suburb or a street that has a lot of one type of house, maybe old Queenslanders, and then you'll have this really modern mid-century sort of international style looking house, and you just wonder where that came from and who was the person that requested that to be built as well. So yeah, you can come across some really intriguing things as well.
Mm. What about your own home?
Oh, my home's pretty boring. It's a unfortunately. Yeah, it's a, well, I say boring, but it was a 1960s, I think probably a spec home built by a builder where they bought a whole lot of land and built a range of houses, affordable houses. And one thing that I try to do with my work is reinforce that it's not just about pretty old houses. The everyday houses were very important, and it's what 90% of people in Brisbane lived in as well. So one of my areas of interest is housing commission homes and social housing, because they really employed some innovative techniques after the war to build houses as quickly as possible. And for example, there's some houses out at Inala that were poured concrete, which had never been done in Brisbane before, and it was an amazing technique, and they could build the houses very quickly. So, and surprisingly, they're quite spacious and quite nice to live in inside as well. So there's all kinds of quirky places in Brisbane, and even the most humble home has an interesting story most of the time.
Absolutely. Marianne Taylor, it's great to talk with you. Fascinating. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
That is the House Detective, and hopefully we've expanded your brain a little bit there.
Emma Griffiths on ABC Radio Brisbane.